नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज मनीषा सिंह। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू कार्गो इंश्योरेंस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज कार्गो इंश्योरेंस? लीगली ऑल द कैरियर्स मस्ट कैरी अ मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस, दैट इज नोन एज कैरियर लायबिलिटी। हाउएवर, कैरियर लायबिलिटी प्रोवाइड्स वेरी लिमिटेड कवरेज एंड एनीथिंग फ्रॉम नेचुरल डिजास्टर्स टू व्हीकल एक्सीडेंट्स और इवन एक्ट्स ऑफ वॉर कुड डैमेज योर कार्गो। देयरफॉर शिपर्स आर रिक्वेस्टेड at cargo insurances to protect their goods from loss, damage or theft while in transit. Generally, goods are insured while being stored and while in transit until they reach the buyer. Does cargo insurance have limitation? So cargo insurance does have limitations. For example, when shipping via truck in the United States, cargo insurance does not provide protection against all the losses does cargo insurance have limitations then cargo insurance does have limitations for example when shipping via truck in the united states cargo insurance does not provide protection against all losses a motor carrier may be liable for under the Carmack amendment or common law. There is not a single standard form of cargo insurance that a carrier can buy and be fully protected. Similarly, a certificate of insurance stating that a motor carrier has a specific amount of cargo insurance does not mean that shippers or brokers' valid claim will be covered by that insurance. There are different types of cargo insurance policies, some going by names such as all risk, broad form, legal liability and motor truck freight. Regardless of what the name might imply, none of these policies provide complete protection against the Carmack amendment and common law liability. Policies exclude coverage in many different ways. For example, certain types of cargo are excluded. Only specific equipment and terminals are covered. Losses caused by certain events are not covered, or coverage applies only if a service is performed in a certain way. Overall, it's a crucial for shippers to document their cargo's value in case of disputes, losses or damages. It may be necessary to work with a lawyer and insurance agent to fully understand your policy and make sure you are protected. Types of cargo insurance. Cargo insurance can be taken for international as well as domestic transportation. At the same time, this is really difficult to standardize and control without the proper cooperation from countries and states due to varying nature of this insurance. Under these variations, this insurance can be categorized into the following classifications. Then land cargo insurance. This insurance provides coverage for all the land transportation covering trucks and other small utility vehicles. And the coverage aspects are theft, collusion, damages, and other related risk. This insurance is domestic in nature and normally operates within the boundaries of the nation. Next is marine cargo insurance. This insurance covers transportation carried are either in air or in sea. Here, means of transportation and goods are covered from damage due to the cargo loading, unloading, weather contingencies, piracies, and other relevant issues. Mostly, this insurance covers international transportation. Under these insurances, there are some policies which can help you in understanding the concept of cargo insurance in a profound manner. These policies are open cover cargo policies when insurance holder opts for coverage against various consignments. Then open cover cargo policies get activated. These policies are segmented in two categories, namely renewable policy and permanent policy. Renewable policy is required for a particular value requiring renewal after policy expiration. Most of the single trip or voyages fall under this category. Permanent policy can be drawn up for a decided time period, permitting countless shipments in that period. Then specific cargo policies. When a company approaches an insurance company or broker for insuring a particular consignment, then it can fall under the category of specific cargo policies. These policies are also termed as voyage policies because only shipments are covered under them. Then next is contingency insurance policy. There are certain cases where customer, not the seller, is responsible for insuring the goods against loss or damage. There are perils associated with it if goods get damaged during transit and customer refuses to accept them. In few cases, some customers do not insure the goods and tend to avoid the liability. Under such circumstances, affected sellers can seek rectification with the help of the legal system, and this can be very costly for them, and sometimes they may cause the case, they may lose the case. Therefore, sellers are advised to go for the contingency insurance, and which have a very less premium rate for testing and verification. Sellers need not tell about it to their customers. Then benefits of cargo insurance. Cargo insurance covers transit carried out in water, air, road, rail, registered post parcel and courier. Following aspects are covered under the benefits of this insurance. All risk coverage. This coverage provides extensive protection against damage or loss due to the external factors. Though this is all called all risk coverage, but still people should know the aspects included and excluded in the policy. Under all risk coverage, included aspects are damages due to inappropriate packaging, infestation, cargo abandonment, then customs rejection, employees dishonesty. Free from particular average coverage, maritime insurance related is free of particular average. Coverage clauses excludes coverage partial losses to the cargo or to the hull except those resulting from stranding, sinking, burning or collision. Another important aspect of this clause is that the shipper does not pay for minor losses and is only held liable in case of significant losses to the cargo. This insurance coverage belongs to the special category and covers particular perils only. There is a difference in coverage depending upon the storage location of the cargo, and in this policy, following perils are included. That is collision, heavy weather, sinking, derailment, non-delivery, theft, fire, and earthquake. General average coverage is, this coverage is basic requirement in the marine cargo transits. More specifically, it covers only partial loss occurred to the shipment, and it requires all other cargo holding owners on the ship to pay compensation to the periled cargo owner. Next is warehouse to warehouse coverage. This coverage is applicable when shipment is unloaded from the ship and it gets transported to the customer's warehouses. Insurance companies are very particular about compensating only the insurance holder's cargo, not the owner's cargoes. Hope you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, ONCE University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever we have a live session. Thank you so much for watching this.